हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मायशेल प्रियंका झा एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लास 10 साइंस केमिस्ट्री चैप्टर 4 एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज कार्बनेट कंपाउंड्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द सिंबल ऑफ कार्बन इज सी एंड इट्स एटॉमिक इज 6 एंड एटॉमिक मास इज 12 एंड इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द पीरियोडिक टेबल इन ग्रुप 14। Dear students, as we know that two or more elements combine to form compound, there are two types of compounds, organic compounds and inorganic compounds. Organic compounds are the one which are made up of carbon and hydrogen. Covalent bond. Carbon has a unique property to form covalent bond. The bond formed by sharing a pair of electrons between two atoms are known as covalent bond. Carbon forms covalent bond. Carbon exists in two forms, as free state and as combined state. Free form of carbon is found in graphite, diamond and fluorine. In combined state, carbon exists as carbon dioxide, glucose, sugar, etc. Allotropes of carbon. Different forms of an element that has same chemical properties but different physical properties are known as allotropes. There are three allotropes of carbon: diamond, graphite and fluorine. Diamond exists as three-dimensional network with a strong carbon-carbon covalent bonds. Diamond is hard in nature with high melting point. It shines in presence of light and it is a bad conductor of electricity. The most common use of diamond is in making jewelry. It is also used in cutting and drilling tools. Graphite is made from weak van der Waals forces. Each carbon atom is bonded with other three carbon atoms in order to form hexagonal rings. It serves as good conductor of heat and electricity. It is used as dry lubricant for machine parts, as well as it is used in lead pencils. Fluorine, it is a hollow case which exists in the form of a sphere. Its structure is similar to fluorine, but along with hexagonal rings, sometimes pentagonal or heptagonal rings are also present. This is the diagram of structure of fluorine. Two important properties of carbon: cationation and tetravalency are the two important properties of carbon. Cationation is a property of carbon by which carbon atoms can link one another via covalent bond and can form long chains, closed ring or branched chains, etc. Carbon atoms can be linked by single, double or triple bonds. Carbon has a valency of 4, due to which it is known to have tetravalency. Due to this, one carbon atom can bond with other 4 carbon atoms, with other atoms also, such as oxygen, nitrogen, etc. Hydrocarbons. Compounds which are made up of carbon and hydrogen, they are known as hydrocarbons. There are two types of hydrocarbons found: saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Saturated hydrocarbons consist of single bonds between the carbon atoms. For example, alkanes are saturated hydrocarbons represented by a formula CnH2n+2. Unsaturated hydrocarbons are the one with double or triple bonds between the carbon atoms. For example, alkenes and alkynes are the types of unsaturated hydrocarbons. Alkenes are represented as CnH2n, whereas alkynes are represented as CnH2n-2. Some saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons are represented as below: methane CH4, ethane C2H6, propane C3H8, butane C4H10, pentane C5H12, C6H14 is hexane, C7H16 is heptane, and C8H18 octane, and C9H20 nonane, and C10H22 decane. These are the examples of saturated hydrocarbons. All saturated hydrocarbons are represented by single bond or single line. Example of alkenes: ethene, The formula of ethene is C2H4, propene C3H6, 1 butane C4H8, 1 pentene C5H10, 1 hexene C6H12, 1 heptene C7H14, 1 octene C8H16. These are the examples of unsaturated hydrocarbons. So dear students, in this video lesson, we learn about carbon and its unique properties, and hydrocarbons, saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons and their examples. And our next video topic is bonding in carbon. So thanks.